जय गुरुदेव चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट चैप्टर स्किम्पल शैंक्स द रेलवे कैट फ्रॉम यूनिट 1. दिस पोएम इज रिटन बाय T.S. एलियट. व्हाइल आई गो थ्रू द पोएम, यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू फोकस योर अटेंशन एट द वर्ड्स एंड देयर प्रोनंसिएशन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. देयर इज अ विस्पर डाउन द लाइन एट 11:39 व्हेन द नाइट मेल्स इज रेडी टू डिपार्ट. Saying, Skimble, where is Skimble? Has he gone to hunt the thimble? We must find him or the train can't start. All the guards and all the porters and all station master's daughters, they are searching high and low. Saying, Skimble, where is Skimble? Or unless he is very nimble. Then the night mail just can't go. At 11:42, then the signal's nearly due and the passengers are frantic to man. Then Skimble will appear and he will saunter to the rear. He has been busy in the luggage van. He gives one flash of his glass green eyes. Next. And the signal goes all clear and we are off at last for the northern part of the northern hemisphere. You may say that by and large it is Skimble who is in the charge of the sleeping car express. From the driver and the guards to the bagman playing cards, he will supervise them all, more or less. Down the corridor he paces and examines all the faces of the travelers in the first and in the third. He establishes control by a regular patrol and he would know at once if anything occurred. He will watch you without winking and he sees what you are thinking. And it's certain that he doesn't improve of hilarity and right. So the folk are very quiet when Skimble is about and on the move. You can play no pranks with Skimble Shanks. He is a cat that cannot be ignored, so nothing goes wrong on the northern mail when Skimble Shank is aboard. Oh, it's very pleasant when you have found your little den with your name written up on the door. And the berth is very neat with a newly folded sheet, and there is not a speck of dust on the floor. There is every sort of light. You can make it dark or bright. There is a button that you turn to make a breeze. There is funny little basin you are supposed to wash your face in, and a crank to shut the window if you sneeze. Then the guard looks in politely and will ask you very brightly, do you like your morning tea weak or strong? But Skimble's just behind him and was ready to remind him, for Skimble won't let anything go wrong. And when you creep into your cozy berth and pull up the counterpane, you are bound to admit that it's very nice to know that you won't be bothered by mice. You can leave all that to the railway cat, the cat of the railway train. In the middle of the night, he is always fresh and bright. Every now and then, he has a cup of tea with perhaps a drop of scotch while he is keeping on the watch, only stopping here and there to catch a flea. You were fast asleep at Crewe, and so you never knew that he was walking up and down the station. You were sleeping all the while he was busy at Carlisle, where he greets the station master with elation, but you saw him at Dumfries, where he summons the police. If there's anything they ought to know about, when you get to Gallowgate there, you do not have to wait, for Skimble Shanks will help you to get out. He gives you a wave of his long brown tail, which says, I'll see you again. You will meet without fail on the midnight mail, the cat of the railway train. Now let us go through meaning of some difficult words. First is thimble. It is a metal protection against rope. Next is nimble. Nimble is very quick, very fast. Okay, cat is very nimble. Its speed is fast. Saunter, walk slowly. Saunter is walk slowly. Rear means to take care. Taking care is called rearing. Next, winking. Wink means open and close your eyes quickly. Aboard, to be on boat, to be on train. Den here refers to a cabin. Crank, a shaft to open the tap. It is a metal shaft to open the tap. Next is creep. Creep into means to get into. Counterpane, glass window. Scotch is a type of drink. Flea, an insect. Clear? Now explanation. Before explaining the poem, let me tell you again that this poem is about the railway cat, who is in charge of the station, and he is so devoted towards his duty that he doesn't let anything wrong in his presence. How does he manage everything? This we will come to know about him in this poem. So let's start. As the poem begins, there is some whisper. As you can see, there is a whisper down the line at 11:39 when the night mail is ready to depart, saying, Skimble, where Skimble has he gone to hunt the thimble? There is whisper along the railway line at 11:39 when the train night mail is ready to leave. Everybody is looking for the cat. They guess that he has gone to hunt the thimble. Thimble, as I told you, is a protection against the rope. They all want him immediately, as the train cannot start unless he comes. All the guards, porters and station master's daughters are searching him everywhere. Skimbleshank is known for his agility. The night mail just can't go without him. Now it is 11:42. As you can see, passengers are getting impatient. The poet says that Skimble will appear soon and handle everything. Actually, he is busy in the luggage van. Describing his eyes, he says that he has a glass green eyes which radiate. As the cat signals all clear, the train departs to the northern part. Now we know that Skimbleshank is in charge of the sleeping car express. He supervises everything and everybody at the station, be it the guard, driver or the bagman playing cards. As he walks along, he examines every face. He establishes control by the regular patrolling. And he suspects anything wrong. He will watch you without getting his eyes blink. When he assures that nothing happens like riot and hilarity, he quietly moves on. The poet says that he is very serious and you can play no prank with him. You cannot ignore him and take him for granted. So, nobody dares to hinder the working at the station where Skimbleshank is on duty. The poet says that it is good when one finds his name written on the door of his cabin. The berth is very neat, not even a speck of dirt is seen. There is newly folded sheet lying on the berth. Every sort of light is available, dim or bright. There is fan, a funny little basin you can wash your face, and a window you can sneeze out. Next, then the guard looks in politely and will ask you very brightly. Guards are very polite and hospitable. They ask for the tea, weak or strong. Then all are trained, they all are trained and instructed by this Kimball Shank. He does not let anyone to be casual in his duty. The atmosphere of the cabin is very nice. When one opens a counterpane, he is bound to marvel. Outside scenario is awesome. Even mice don't bother. All this owing to Kimball Shank. You can see Kimball Shank fresh and active even in the midnight. To keep himself active, he has a cup of tea. He also takes a drop of scotch to remain vigilant all the time. He catches fleas so that no one gets disturbed. They don't even know that Scat is walking up and down and guiding them. All are fast asleep. Kimball Shank is busy at Carlisle, where he greets the station master with a good gesture. At Dumfries, where he calls the police and helps him to know about everything. And when he's at Gallowgate, he helps you to get out of the station. He waves at you and says, "I will see you again." So one can meet him anytime on the midnight mail. She is available all time.